I would like to take you on a journey and invite you to come with me to the beach. So if you dare, you can close your eyes and listen to my voice. Imagine you're sitting on a beach, enjoying the warmth of the sun, listening to the waves as they wash up and down. The sun sparkles on the sea, and a bird flies overhead. You breathe in the salty air. A big wave crashes, and you feel the ocean mist cool on your skin. And as the waves wash up and down, grains of sand tumble along the shore. You feel the softness of the sand under your hand and feet. You pick up the sand and you look at it closely. You see different colors and sizes, and you imagine it comes from mountains and deserts far away. And now it's here with you in your hand, brought by rivers and sea. You're holding small particles of the world in your hand. You can open your eyes now. If I look at these grains, I imagine they come from far, and that every grain has its own story to tell. It tells about people, about landscape. And for me, these grains are very important. The more I zoom in, the more I learn from geology, history, and the land we live on. I feel a moment of pure joy. So why is it important? Why does it matter? Sand is everywhere. But without sand, we wouldn't have buildings, we wouldn't have glass, we wouldn't have a computer. Your iPhone is made out of sand. Dubai is, for example, taking whole beaches away from Australia to put into concrete. The sea bottom is stretched to build and to make houses. We are running out of sand, and that's very strange because we have a lot. So, for example, the industry is only using white sand to produce all the glass all over the world and also to make our microchips. And all these quarries, they are getting exhausted. They are overmined. In my work, I look at these grains of sand and I look at their different character. The black volcanic sands, the limestones, pink sands, desert sands. What can they tell me? They are small, but they have a big story to tell if we take time to listen. We went on a journey 6 years long to explore all sands of beaches and dunes, deserts, to understand those landscapes and to see the difference from a beach to wood. And in the wood you can find twigs, on the beach you find shelves, and these landscapes, they tell about stories and about people and culture. We experimented for many years to make our own glass recipes. It took super long because the industry wasn't helping us, because if we would come with our dirty sands, they would say, not in my oven, because we are using this oven with pure white sands. And I would say, these sands are not polluted, these are rich sand, and they deliver beautiful color. They are not perfect, but they are beautiful green and blue, and even they give new material. So we had to build our own oven to make it possible, because even the smallest glass blower is using white sands and colors afterwards. So that's what we did. And last year, we managed to make our own glass from a beach close to Scheveningen. Maybe you all know that. And from a wood in Maastricht. And this has a very dark green color because there is a lot of iron in the sand. So the sand is telling what it becomes. It's always a gift. It's a nature gift. So we never know before what comes out of the oven. So we're playing with sand. It's our life. This is me and Nadine in the dunes of Brabant. We recently made glass from the dunes there. And our last project is called To See a World in a Grain of Sand. We invited people to actually collaborate with us, to make a collaborative artwork, and to send us sand from all over the world, along with stories and pictures. And we asked them, why is this sand important for you? And this was a very beautiful moment, because I got presents all summer. The mailman is now very famous to us. And we got sands from holiday, but from another one because he was married on the beach, or somebody building his first house, children who were playing on the beach, somebody who was looking for their motherland. And the stories I got, they are really incredible. And it shows us how we're all connected and how we're all connected by sand and earth. One neighbor of me, he came to me and he said, like, actually, I'm going to an island already for many years in Ameland. But this time it was different, because this time I was with my three daughters and they wanted to find their own sand. And they explored the island and came back with three different types of sand. And I have seen this island in a new way. And this is actually very beautiful, because we can see everything around us in a new way if we start looking. And what I think is really nice with the stories we got from the people is also the questions. People are asking, is it actually allowed to take this sand from the beach? It's so beautiful, so valuable. Can I just send it to you? And this is actually a very good question. Why can we just take sand from a beach, which has such a huge value, we cannot live without? And this is also where it starts, and this is also where it starts with me and Nadine. It didn't start with, we want to save the world, we're going to make a solution for the scarcity problem. No, it started with fascination with this beautiful material. And this bottle of sand, which is sent by these people, contains a story and their memory, and it's a celebration, so it becomes word of gold. And we are all here together, like grains of sand on a beach, and together we can make beautiful colors. Thank you.